Hello friends, I am Vipin Sharma, Assistant Professor, ECE Department. In the previous two lectures, in the series Measurement, System Performance and Error, we have completed two lectures, and in these two lectures, we discuss about various characteristics of measurement system and error analysis. Error analysis means how we add, subtract, multiply or divide quantities which has some relative error. So in the previous lecture we discussed about some formulae for addition, subtraction, multiplication, division and some composite values, composite formulas. Now here we will try to understand these formula in our with the help of our some numerical problems. So here our first numerical is the value of capacitance of a capacitor is specified as 1 microfarad and plus minus 5% by the manufacturer. Find limits between which the value of the capacitance is guaranteed. So first we understand the question. Here manufacturer specified a capacitor whose value is 1 microfarad with relative percentage error of 5%. So he is asking about the range of the capacitance value. Or now to solve this, our given specified value is 1 microfarad and relative error is 5%. It is given in percentage. So we from the previous lecture we have the formula. The guaranteed value of the capacitance lie within the limits, as we have already discussed, that actual value of the capacitance is equal to the specified value multiplied by 1 plus minus epsilon r. Epsilon r is relative error. This value is not in percentage, but here value is given in percentage, 5%. 5% is equal to 5 by 100, which is equal to 0.05. It means epsilon r is 0.05. Now AS is 1 microfarad and our actual value, range of the actual value will be 1 microfarad multiplied by 1 plus minus 0.05. It means once this quantity will be added to 1 and second time it is subtracted from 1. So range will be 1 minus 0.05 into 1 microfarad to 1 plus 0.05 into 1 microfarad, which is equivalent to 0.95 microfarad to 1.05 microfarad. So hope this first question is clear to you. Now my second question. Second question is, a 0 to 150 volt meter has guaranteed accuracy of 1% of full scale reading. The voltage measured by this instrument is 75 volt. Calculate the limiting error in percent and comment upon the results. So here first we understand the question. Here we have given a voltmeter whose range is 0 to 150 volt. It means its full scale deflection is 150 volt. It is the maximum value which can be measured with the help of this given voltmeter. And the manufacturer specified its guaranteed accuracy of 1%. 1% is given to you is relative percentage error, which is equal to 1%. And this error is with respect to the full scale deflection. And he is asking, if we measure 75 volt with this instrument, what will be the limiting error? And we have to discuss our result also. So now try to solve this question. So first we write what is given to us. The magnitude of limiting error of instrument is, here epsilon r is given, we have to calculate magnitude of the error. Because percentage is given, so we calculate magnitude. Magnitude is defined by delta A, which is equal to epsilon r into AS. AS is specified value. Specified value yani full scale value. Full scale value is here 150 volt. So delta A is equal to epsilon r multiplied by AS, which is equal to epsilon r is given to us in percentage, which is equal to 1%. So convert this into numerical values, which is equal to 1 by 100. It is 0.01 multiplied by 150. So numerical value of error is 1.5 volt. Now the magnitude of the voltage being measured. So we have to measure 75 volt. So relative error for this voltage will be delta A by AS, which is equal to 1.5 divided by 75, which is equal to 0.02. In percentage, it is 2%. Now, I hope this is clear. Now we try to discuss our result. We have to find the range also. Therefore, the voltage being measured within the limits. So this is the range which is I have already given. Actual value is equal to specified value into 1 plus minus of epsilon r for the given measured value. So 75 into 1 plus minus 0.02, which is equivalent to 75 plus minus 1.5 volt. So range will be 73.5 volt to 76.5 volt. Now he is asking discussion. So comments is here. Guarantee error, given guaranteed error is 1% for full scale deflection, which is equal to 150 volt. But when we are measuring 75 volt, the limiting error is 2%, as we calculated in our question. The percentage of limiting error will be greater if smaller voltage is measured. It means as if we are measuring small quantities, then percentage of limiting error will be increased. Let's suppose one another example, we are measuring 37.5 volt with this instrument, then percentage of limiting error will be 1.5 divided by 37.5 into 100, which is equal to 4%. It shows that percentage limiting error increases as the voltage being measured decreases. So this is our discussion of that questions. Now, third question. Third question is saying that the question is, a voltmeter having a range of 1000 watt has an error of plus minus 1% of full scale deflection. If the true power is 100 watt, what would be the range of reading? Now first understand the question. We have a voltmeter which has full scale deflection of 1000 watt. It means maximum power that can be measured with the help of this wattmeter is 1000 watt. And specified and the relative error in percentage is plus minus 1%. This is specified by manufacturer. And this is for full scale deflection. If the true power is 100 watt, if we measure 100 watt power with the help of this instrument, what will be the range of the reading? So now try to solve this. Solution. Here for full scale deflection, magnitude of error is, here percentage is given, we have to calculate magnitude. Magnitude of error will be epsilon r, which is equal to 1 by 100 into full scale deflection. Full scale deflection is 1000 watt, which is equal to plus minus 10 watt. Now wattmeter reading, when true reading is 100 watt, so range will be 100 plus minus 10 watts, which is equal to 90 to 110 volts. Hope this question is also clear to you. Now next question, question number four related to the analysis of error. Here we have given some quantities and we have to add, subtract and divide, multiply, then what will be the effect of calculation, effect of limiting error on the resultant value. Now understand this with the help of some numerical problems. Question 4. There are three resistors have the following ratings. R1 resistance, which is given by 37 ohm plus minus 5%. R2 75 ohm plus minus 5%. R3 50 ohm plus minus 5%. Determine the magnitude and limiting error in ohms and in percent of resistance of these resistance connected in series. So first we understand the questions, what we have given and what we have to calculate. We have given three resistance of different values. Here 37 ohm, 75 ohm and 50 ohm are the values of the resistance, and plus minus 5%. Here limiting error given is 5% in each case. So this is percentage of limiting error, plus minus 5%. So what is 5% is percentage of epsilon r, which is equal to delta r 1 upon r 1. So the value of resistance, now we will calculate numerical values in each case. R 1 is equal to 37 plus minus 5%. Numerical value of 5% is equal to 5 by 100 into 37, which is equivalent to 1.85. Similarly, R1, R2 and R3, we calculate numerical values, which is equivalent to 37 plus minus 1.85, 75 plus minus 3.75 and 50 plus minus 2.5. Now, if these resistance are connected in series, so if we connected these all three resistance in series connection, then the resultant will be sum of all these three. So resultant value R will be equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus minus delta R1, delta R2, delta R3. Delta R1 is numerical values of the error, which is equal to 1.85. Delta R2 is numerical value of error in R2 resistance, which is equal to 3.75. And delta R3 is numerical value in the resistance R3, which is given by 2.5. Now delta R is the overall resultant value in the final result R, which is equal to sum of all these errors, which is equivalent to 8.5 ohm. This is the error in the resultant. And resultant value is 37 plus 75 plus 50, which is equal to 162 ohm. So our result will be R is equal to 162 ohm plus minus 8.1 ohm. But he is asking about the percentage of limiting error. Then percentage of limiting error will be delta R by R into multiply by 100, which is equivalent to delta R is 8.1, R is 162, multiply by 100, which is equivalent to plus minus 5%. So hope this question is clear to you. Now here we have to note some important points. First is, if we have n number of resistance and each has same percentage of error, then the final error in the resultant sum of all these resistance will be equivalent to same percentage. And second point here is noted for notation is that we cannot directly add the percentage of error in sum in addition of quantities. We add numerical values of errors. This is important point to remember. Now question 5. Question 5 is, now question 5, here two resistance are given as R1 and R2. R1 is 100 plus minus 6%. R2 is 50 plus minus 4%. Here value is given to us in percentage, error is given in percentage. We converted it into numerical values. 100, 6% of 100 is 6 ohm and 4% of 50 is 2 ohm. Now we have to calculate R1 plus R2, R1 multiply R2, R1 minus R2 and R1 divided by R2. So now try to solve this question. First question, first part is addition of two resistance. R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2. Here R1 is 100 ohm and R2 is 50 ohm. Resultant is 150 ohm. Now limiting error in R equivalent will be delta R equivalent upon R equivalent, which is equal to plus minus, as it is discussed in numerical error analysis, that if we add two quantities, then the resultant error will be plus minus R1 upon R equivalent into delta R1 by R1 plus R2 by R equivalent into delta R2 by R2. Here delta R1 by R1 is equal to the relative error. If we multiply it by 100, it will be percentage. Here percentage is given, so we convert it into delta R1 by delta R1 by R1 and delta R2 by R2, which is equivalent to delta R1 by R1 is 6%, delta R2 by R2 is 4%. Here delta R1 limiting error या fractional error 6 by 100, 6% is given. Here delta R1 is 6 ohm. Delta R2 by R2, 4% is given, which is equivalent to 4 by 100. So delta R2 is 2 ohm. Now delta R equivalent upon R equivalent is equal to plus minus. R equivalent is, sorry, R1 is 100 and R equivalent 150 multiply by 6 plus 50 upon 150 multiply by 4 is equal to 5.33. And we have to calculate in percentage, we write percentage here because 6%, 4% and the resultant will be in percent. 5.33%. Now R equivalent is 150 plus minus 5.33%. This result is in percentage. If in numerical values, we have to calculate R equivalent, what will be the 5.33% of 150 ohm, which is equivalent to 8 ohm. And 8 ohm is equivalent to 6 plus 2 ohm is equal to 8 ohm. Delta R1 plus delta R2. So as I have already discussed that in addition of two quantity, we cannot directly add percentage limiting error, but we can add directly limiting error numerical values. Here delta R1 and delta R2 are numerical values, not percentage value. That's why we add directly 8 ohm. So we can solve this question using two method. One, both are discussed here. One in, is in percentage form and second one is in numerical values. Oh, this point is clear to you. Now we multiply these two quantities. R1, R2 is equal to R equivalent. R equivalent is 100 plus minus 6% into 50 plus minus 4%, which is equal to 5000 plus minus 10%. As multiplication, we can directly add percentage limiting error. Here, second question is multiplication of R1, R2 is equivalent to R equivalent. R equivalent is 100 plus minus 6% multiply by 50 plus minus 4%, which is equivalent to 5000 plus minus 10%. As we have already told you that in multiplication, we can add directly percentage limiting error, not numerical value, numerical values of the given quantities, but we cannot add directly numerical values of limiting error. I mentioned this point here. Now, difference of two quantities. In difference and sum, formula is same. So, error will be delta R equivalent is equal to 100. R equivalent is R1 minus R2, which is equivalent to 50 ohm. Now, delta R equivalent upon R equivalent is R equivalent upon R1 into delta R1 upon R1 plus R2 divided by R equivalent multiply by delta R2 by R2, which numerical values is 100 upon 50 into 6 plus 50 upon 50 into 4, which is equivalent to 16%. 16% of R equivalent is 8 ohm. So R equivalent is 50 plus minus 16%, which is equivalent to 50 plus minus 8 ohm. Now division. In division, we can directly add the error. R1 by R2 is 100 upon 50, which is equivalent to 2, and delta R equivalent upon R equivalent is 6% in R1 error in R1 and 4% in R error in R2. So add these to 10%. Now our result will be 10% of the R equivalent, which is equivalent to 0.02. So R equivalent will be 2 plus minus 10%, and numerical we get 2 plus minus 0.02 ohm. Now I mentioned these two important points. We add directly numerical values of error in addition and subtraction. We can add directly percentage of error directly in case of multiplication and division. Thank you. In next lecture, we will discuss about types of classification of error and various characteristics of measuring system. Till now, till then, bye. Thank you.